flawless, my dear.
Well, perhaps I can come with you. I've always wanted to live in a castle.
If Daphne is going to take anyone with her, Gregory, it will be me.
The two of you are staying here until our dear sister allows us a visit.
I mean, if she allows us a visit, I'm quite sure you'll enjoy the peace and quiet.
I'm going to miss all of you. Terribly.
Even me?
Even you.
Thank you, Humboldt. No need to send anyone up.
I want you to know I'm not angry with you. I do not blame you for what transpired.
Do not treat me like a child. I did this.
He took advantage of you.
No less than I took liberties with him.
You do not understand it. I should have protected you better. I knew his true nature from the start.
You certainly make it look difficult.
I beg your pardon?
Not with your constant struggles. You cannot manage it, can you?
Haste.
Your responsibility. You, fulfilling the promise that every firstborn son makes to his father before he dies. Do you think he is looking down on you now? Ashamed? Mortified at what you have done? I wonder what would the former Viscount say?
You barely know the young lady. What on earth were you thinking?
I was thinking you would probably respond like this and how little I would care to hear.
Do you think this is a joke? Poor mother was beside herself.
Mother seems perfectly happy to me. She congratulated us.
So, you compromised this young lady?
Certainly not. I'm a gentleman.
Then why ever would you...
Why does anyone marry, brother? Love, of course.
Look, I know you are still rather green, and... That is my fault. I should have taken you to brothels when you returned home from Eton. So if this is simply a matter of wetting your wick...
You really are an ass. Do you know that?
This is what comes of not sowing your wild oats. Proposing to the first chick you set your cap at.
Enough! You insult me and you insult my intended. It is not my fault, nor Marina's, that you cannot fathom true attachment.
You are still a child, Colin.
I'm older than Daphne and you were happy to marry her.
It is not the same, you know it.
I know nothing of the sort.
Then you betray your immaturity!
If I caused Mother discomfort today, I am sorry for it. I shall speak with her. The truth is, I do not require your permission to marry Miss Thompson, but I would very much prefer to have your blessing.
Then I'm afraid I must disappoint you.
You have. In more ways than one.
Clear this morning.
Is it your wish me to insult your sister, Bridgerton?
On the contrary.
You wish your sister to marry a loathsome toad, but...
Lord Bridgerton!
Forgive the intrusion, but if need be, I will happily restate my intentions with respect to your sister. She's a prize I have long coveted. For her beauty, for her grace.
For her powerful right hook.
I must know whether I can count on you.
I should like to know what is going on.
Oh, I would like to know the very same. Perhaps we might begin with why you chose to interrupt such an exquisite morning.
Because she is already engaged to be married.
The Duke has already asked for your hand.
I'm not engaged, Mama. Has anyone truly proposed to me? No. Have I proposed to anyone else? I do not believe I have.
Do not be disrespectful, sister.
Disrespectful?
Of course, mere hearsay of such a scandal could wreak havoc on even the most influential of families. What would someone like, say, Lady Whistledown do with such unseemly information?
Is that a threat?
It is certainly not. Because in 3 days, I am to marry. I have the diamond of the season. I have the very best that Ton has to offer. I have a Bridgerton, and I shall save her, as well as your entire family, from the ruin which you could not protect them.
Bastard!
Anthony!
You'll marry her.
What?
Immediately. We can only hope that no one saw you take such liberties and that my sister is safe. Further mortification. You will marry her!
Brother!
I cannot marry her.
You have defiled her innocence, and now you refuse her hand. I knew you were rake, Hastings. I never thought you were a villain.
We have all things in order, sister. We do not require your assistance.
Oh, well, that is simply not true, Anthony, and you know it. Daphne may be the answer to all of our problems. Oh, once the Tarns see that we still have the favor of the Duke and the Duchess, then the whispers may very well cease. and we shall go about our daily lives as if nothing has happened, as if nothing is awry.
And no one will be the wiser. Or pretending that nothing is amiss is the perfect way to lure the ignorant into submission. Is it not, Mama? Now.
I have one last matter to discuss with you.
You've already provided ample instruction. I shall contact the solicitor
and safeguard our system.
An additional task. In the top drawer of my desk, you shall find the name of a lady. If I die, you must ensure she is provided for. Do you swear? Benedict, do you
swear? Brother.
That is all.
Did you know about this?
People are looking to congratulate the happy couple. Anthony, tell me you did not.
He's a fine choice. I looked into him.
You promised your sister to that man.
Not well enough, apparently.
What?
Does not matter. I now have many choices indeed. I do not need...
You have suitors. You do not have what matters, proposals. Except, of course, from Lord Burbrook.
Whatever happened to his eye? It's quite grotesque.
They're all staring, Mother.
Allow them to come to you, dear.
Recently written of you. Presumptuous. Clearly. Arrogant, most definitely.
Then you leave me no choice. I must demand satisfaction.
A duel? Anthony, you cannot...
He dishonors you, sister. He dishonors you and me and the very Bridgerton name. Mother? Duff?
Did you truly take your sister to a boxing match, Anthony?
Your admonishment will have to wait. I have news. Prince Friedrich has asked for my permission to propose.
So soon?
Well, what did you tell him?
That I know better than to answer for my sister. I have no objections to the man. People speak well of him. Whatever you decide, Daff, you shall have my support.
Miss Anna Vaughan speaks several languages, I hear. Miss Mary Egglesfield, now she's meant to be quite the read.
Were I looking for a list of debutantes and their dubious accomplishments, I could have stayed home and read Lady Whistledown.
No.
I have misjudged you indeed. You have duped us both, but I shall not see my sister pay for my own misdeeds. We will settle this as gentlemen.
I understand. I shall see you at dawn.
I do not understand. You would rather die than marry me.
I am truly sorry.
We need to go, Dove, before anyone should see us. Miss Thompson must be in agonies over these lies. Why can I not visit her?
Colin...
Listen to me, brother. That the Ton devours every bit of Whistledown's on D is the only thing keeping this family from shame. Because of her column, no one believes you are the father of Miss Thompson's child. But if you were to go near her, then they will presume you're responsible for her ruin, and all your sisters will pay the price for your notoriety. Is this what you desire? Well, of course not, but...
Evening, everyone.
Dearest.
What are you doing here, Daff? Should you not be frolicking in newlywed bliss?
I can't...
Sister has a headache. I'm taking her home. See to Mother, will you?
Daphne, you're looking well. Did you catch a chill in the garden?
Sister! Sister! Stand aside!
Oh, good God.
Are you hurt? Tell me!
Perfectly well. No thanks to you, idiot.
What the hell do you think you're playing at?
Says the man who just shot at me.
You just rode into the middle of a duel.
I require a moment with the Duke.
Daphne,
I require a moment with the Duke.
Make it brief. Anthony, Daff.
If the only upstanding gentlemen present this evening are your brothers, then we're in a great deal of trouble indeed.
You continue to say we.
Did Ma tell you yet?
about my tour. I'm to begin in Greece.
Greece? How adventurous, Colin.
Oh, God.
Too late. I already noted you. Miss Bridgerton, you look rather lovely this evening. Is there a reason I've yet to see you on the dance floor?
All in good time, Lady Danbury.
Poor thing.